Hi, this is Exploring with Em and Stu.
I'm Em.
And I'm Stu.
And today we've returned to Happisburgh here in Norfolk to explore the World War II gun batteries.
During World War II, the small coastal village of Happisburgh on the Norfolk coast played an important part in helping to win the Battle of Britain. As well as a radar station sited further inland, an emergency coastal gun battery was built on the clifftop to help defend against the enemy. Hastily built in 1940, the gun battery consisted of two gun houses with their ex-naval 4.7 inch guns, which would have originally been camouflaged as haystacks, as well as a large network of underground tunnels and rooms. Surrounding the gun houses, there would have been various spigot mortars and a pillbox, which the remains can still be seen, as well as an observation post, artillery searchlights, all surrounded by a large barbed wire fence, but all since long demolished. The area was also chosen for the construction of a Royal Observer Corps during the Cold War. Better known as an ROC post, little or no trace of it can now be found.
Right, okay, we're in the first part of this gun battery.
This is the south gun house.
Yeah, I can see it's all rotting away up there. But we have returned back here because we promised ourselves we'll do a better video.
We've been here once or twice before, back in the early days.
So
we know a bit more about the place now.
Yeah.
As you would have just heard.
Yeah, exactly. So what we're gonna do is, I'll show you actually, we're gonna be going down to this part of the tunnel, which is down here. But the amazing tunnel is actually from this building here, this part of the battery.
Yes. These are gun houses.
Yeah, there's gun houses, and you can see just here, actually, this is where a gun pivot would have been.
I think it's a 6.7 ounce or pounder or
something like that, yeah. And then just for record, I'd like to show you this. I don't know if they're actually still on here. Oh, yeah, they are. If you see just up here where this bit of wire's hanging down, they up there used to be hooks, didn't they?
Do you know what the fascinating thing about these is that not a lot of people know was that they were both thatched.
Yeah,
originally,
thatched, yeah.
Because they would with straw to disguise them as hay bales.
Hay bales, that's right, yeah.
For camouflage them from the old aeroplanes.
There you go.
So yeah, that's quite amazing.
And that's it really.
This
I mean,
would have obviously had searchlights to the north and south,
yeah.
Surrounded by barbed wire.
Yeah.
I believe it had channels from the searchlights going out towards the sea. I mean obviously we've lost a lot of the coast here, but there was an awful lot more here than what we see now. So,
exactly.
It's also supposed to be Cold War ROC post, which we're
going to
try and hunt out later.
Yeah, we'll try.
Where it used to be, anyway.
Yeah, it used to be.
So let's get down there.
We're going to use my new torch, as you can see. It's actually a copy of an Olight, but we're going to.
Hopefully, you won't lose this one.
No, this one, yeah, I lost my last one. That was a brilliant one. It's a military one.
It
was amazing, I know. So we're going to go down here now. So bear with us. Okay, as you can see there, they're probably ammunition lockers. Me and Emma were just discussing it.
Like an additional.
It does. But the most important thing, we know that you lot want to get down here, so we're going to get down here.
We don't want to get down here quite so much because we know this one is full of rubbish.
This one's awful.
And rats, apparently.
Yeah.
So if you hear Stu squeal, you know what it is.
Yeah, it's rats. We've been down here, I think this is our third time now. It's cave full of. It's always full of cave spiders as well. Like a freaking ape. Ugh. Yeah, there's loads of fresh rat droppings down here, as you can see.
Beautiful.
Yep. Yeah, it looks like this place has actually been dragged a lot more, and everything. So.
You know what? They don't look like there's quite so much rubbish.
No, but. Yeah, it looks like it's all been spread out and there's loads of gnats down here. We always find there's loads of gnats. But you can understand why the rats are here, I tell you.
Yeah. Not the favourite place to go, is it?
No, but as you can see, we're Oh, you can hear things in there going on, yeah. Okay. All right, we'll stay out that way. Coming in, Emma. This is Emma's little project today. She wanted to come down here. All right. These are amazing, these things. We always find these quite fascinating, the light switches all burnt out. And now, what are you doing?
Taking a picture of it.
Oh, right.
Oh, look, Friday the 13th down there.
Oh, brilliant.
On VHS,
if you know what that is, guys. Yeah, VHS, it's for Jason, isn't it? Jason Forkies. But as you can see, there's not actually much down this one, but this has been opened. This was closed up before, this entranceway. This was all closed up. This looks like it's been dug out. It looks like it's...
Why they've done that?
I don't know, considering that entranceway is there, I don't know.
Yeah.
So
it was all full of rubble, wasn't it?
It was.
Dirt, as you can see.
It was, yeah. So, yeah.
Interesting.
So I've just moved the camera light over. I'll tell you what I'll do is I'll move that light off and put it there.
Ventilation
pipes, yeah.
But, yeah, we don't really know what this would have been, do we?
No.
Could have just been...
Storage area, but we don't really like this part because we like the other tunnel. The other tunnel's better than this. But
there used to be some electrical stuff here, didn't there?
Yeah, we've got some of it there. Look, some of it over there. And so it's not much to see in this one. This is just full of rubbish, really. There you go. I'll just extend that so you can see it better. There you go. There you go, so that's this tunnel. There's not much to see in this tunnel.
Nah, we thought we'd give a quick look anyway.
Yeah. Alright then, so we're gonna head back up now. So we'll see you in a second. That will be literally in the best part of the tunnel. You are still there. Alright, see you in a sec. Bye. Right, we're out of the tunnel now. Don't know if you can hear us with the wind and everything else, we haven't got the mic. But what we're heading north for now is over to here. So bear with us. We'll see you in a second over there. Okay, now we're in the North Gun Battery. Is it North One? The North Gun Battery?
North Gun House.
Yeah, the North Gun House. As you can see again, we've got ammunition closets there. And just behind us, these two here.
It's just a replica of what
It's literally a replica of what you can see. But we'll take you outside and we'll, you know, go through it with you. Okay, so we come out here. That's the first one that we did was here. This one again is practically the same, identical, same gun plinth, but with a bit of a difference this side. Emma's going to attempt later on, which she hasn't done yet.
Previous visits,
no. We're going to try and get down this hole here. I'm not going to be able to do it, but Emma will, just down here. And obviously, you know the sheer size of me compared to Emma. And can we just put on camera who volunteered for it and who said you don't do it, but you're doing it anyway?
Yeah, I know.
Right, okay. Yeah. So people will say things.
I don't have to, but I want to. I've got to do it because I've been here three times. I've never managed it, but so I'm doing it.
Exactly. But as you can see here, this would have been a tunnel entrance.
A sloped stairway down.
Yeah.
And they've blocked it off with concrete.
They've blocked it off.
The same. They would have been the same over there as well.
Yeah.
You would have had.
But we went on the other side of it, and we've already gone down there.
It's completely blocked. But what we do know
is this.
Two gun houses are actually connected by the tunnel.
Yep. And there's our entranceway,
which we'll show you when we get down there.
Just there. And we're going to be going down there. Well, in a minute.
Right, okay.
Always get nervous about this bit.
You do, don't you?
Every time.
But you're much smaller these days.
I know, yeah, I've been losing a lot of weight, so we should be fine. Right. So we'll see you when we get down there.
Yep.
Right, okay, Emma's taking a few deep, sharp breaths and she's going down.
Yeah, I'm going down.
Going down.
There's some brambles there.
Brambles, I'll be careful. Don't forget, on your bum and slide.
Oh, I'm not going on my bum.
Well, you have to.
No, I don't. You have to. Smells foisty.
It would do. It's always damp
torch.
Down there.
Get my torch.
Just getting a torch out there.
Right.
Has it leaked? Is it dry?
Yep.
It's dry, lovely.
Can't see any obvious dead bodies, so that's
fantastic.
Good.
All right. So she's going down there, and I'm passing the bag to Emma. There we go. And I'll be passing mine, so I'll see you in a second. Right.
We're getting dripped on.
We're down here now, so we're going to turn the camera around and start straight away because there's rats running between our feet and everything. So we hope you enjoy this. All right, let's get going. So this is one of the rooms. Now, as far as I know, these are like storage rooms, mostly.
Yeah, I reckon so. They could have used it for ammunition and stuff, couldn't they?
They could have done, yeah.
But, if I can find the map of the place with telling you what a lot of the rooms were, I will. But I don't think they told you what that room was.
No, no. But these places are like really cool.
It's amazing. You've still got these hooks and stuff all up the side here.
Still got.
I guess that's where the wires would have been connected.
Would have been connected, yeah.
Communication maybe.
I can see down there how long that corridor is.
Oh, it's cool, isn't it?
It's always really cool. But we're always nervous about it. Boy, yeah, there's the hooks that you see them up there. Always nervous about the same thing. I've got my torch. No, do you know what? I don't know what it is down here. I get nervous. I love it, but I get nervous about it.
It's just amazing to think that this is underneath just those little gun houses.
Yeah.
And people walk past with their dogs every day.
All the time. No idea what this is in here. We've got the where they've tried to infill it.
Yeah. Well, there was a few buildings, original buildings up there once. I imagine when they demolished them, they just chucked it down these holes.
Exactly.
It's always fascinating.
Right, now we're coming into the bunk room. We believe these are bunk rooms. Is that right?
Well, it was either bunk rooms or it was storage. I personally find it difficult to believe that they were bunk rooms because I would have thought that they would have lived on a camp.
Yeah, I would have thought.
Up the top.
I would have thought.
They're the right size for bunks.
They are.
And it's sort of common knowledge, apparently, that they were bunks. But yeah. maybe somebody can tell us if they agree or disagree.
Yeah, exactly. We've got plenty of them here. You can sort of look how cold it is down. It's ice. Look up there. It's all ice.
It's chewy, isn't it?
Yeah. This is. That looks really clear.
Oh, that's different.
Is that different?
It looks like somebody's given it a sweep, isn't it?
You see all the rat droppings in here. So there'll be a rat just run out in front of me in a minute. I'll just know it. So you can see in here, this is flooded. This wasn't flooded before, this one. But you can see it's been flooded. And you can see the other entrance hole just there.
One of these was like an officer's room or something.
Yeah, I think this was the officer's room. And we think they are original, them barrels.
I imagine they would be, yeah.
We think so.
But there was something certainly there, whether it's some sort of storage area or...
And what we did know about up here, if you have a look here, this is where a chemical toilet would have been, just in there. As you can see the pipework still there. But you can see, if you look up there, you can see all the rat holes.
Yeah, that obviously would have been another entrance. There's many entrances and escape hatches and stuff down in this place, isn't there?
Absolutely.
You can find them lit all over the ceilings.
Yeah, all the time. But we're going to now go over, see if we... Because there's not a lot to see in these tunnels, but there's a lot to see, if you know what I mean.
There's some original door frames, still a piece of wood left.
Yeah.
Well, that's not
going to
be there for too much longer, is it?
No, not at all. Look at that. But we can. This looks like it's been more ruined.
They weren't on the floor, were they? Somebody's trashed it a bit, unfortunately.
I think someone's been down here and trashed it a little tiny bit, yeah.
Shame.
Don't know why they do that.
On the south side of it leads to the south side gunhouse, doesn't
it? Gunhouse, yeah, of course it does. But as you come through here, see, look, you've got rat holes there. See them? Just there. Sorry?
It's such a shame that somebody's ripped that off.
Oh no. It could have just fell off.
Well, it's been sat there for long enough about falling off.
Yeah, so you've got another thing there with the spiders and everything else. Right, and we've got all this fur growing in here. Yeah, look at all the fur.
Oh, it's
mouldy, of course it is. Now we're coming down this bit of tunnel. But as I said, Emma will be You'll have no idea how pitch black it is down here, because it is pitch black. If our torches failed now, we'd be absolutely stuffed. Literally. But
so it's like animal fur.
It looks like it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it looks like it could be rabbits or could be from the rats.
Could be. This is another service entrance. We believe we found this service entrance at the top.
Either that, or that actually could be the way up to the south gun house.
Could be.
That's what we come up with a conclusion at that point of view.
Yeah.
And replicated another little room
and
just down here.
Looks like we've got a chemical toilet, possibly. We don't know what that was. We don't know. We've seen them sort of things built before.
We have, haven't we?
I've
done a good look at that.
Yeah. As you can see, it's another room. But I mean, this is the end of this tunnel now. But yeah.
Yep, that would have. I imagine there would have been stairs that went up.
Yep.
And that's probably the piece of concrete.
Yeah, of course. At the top of
the north entrance of that south.
That's it. Yeah. All right, so.
Oh, God. Shame that this is all going to be in the sea.
Oh, yeah. But it's looking good, because we've got the original hooks there again. And there's a bit of wood, look, I've never noticed this before. There's a bit of wood sitting there.
They'd have had wires connected to
probably,
me.
Yeah.
I guess that all these little bits would
yeah, have all the same.
Communications.
But stuff. Look how clear these pathways are. Very, very clear.
They're quite clean, except for obviously where they've
filled in.
Tried to fill them in.
Yeah. But you can sort of see there's some hay and. It does look like animal fur. There's a possibility.
It's white. I wonder what it is.
Don't know.
Because it's not wool.
No, it's not.
There's no sheep around here.
No.
But yeah, that barrel. Oh, it's plastic.
Yeah, it's a plastic barrel. It's not
these
original.
Pipes would be, wouldn't they?
Yeah, the pipes would have been. Look up there. Look. See the
the
pipes.
Sort of ventilation, maybe.
Yeah.
It's quite cool.
Yeah, it's quite amazing. It is amazing down here.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But we'll be going round again in a minute, and we'll be going up top side. But Emma really wanted to give you a proper explore of it.
Some information, a bit of history about it.
Yeah.
So as you know, one of our most interesting things that we explore are World War II.
Yeah.
Stuff.
Our history stuff.
And we've got really interested in that, haven't we?
One thing that is missing from here last time, there was some metal canteens. Sitting there.
There was a few pots and stuff, wasn't
yeah,
there?
And it looks like that's actually gone missing now.
A lot of this is found as rubbish, isn't it?
A lot of it is, yeah. How it got down here, I don't know, but.
All these bags of fertiliser.
Yeah.
Okay then.
You've got the old fireplace.
Fireplace, I
imagine. Do you know what? That looks like an old wood burner stove thing.
I reckon that was,
yeah. So. But yeah, pretty amazing. Still got some wood up there, wood artifacts and stuff. It's very, very cold and very, very icy. It looks light icy over there. But yeah, so this is it. This is
the main tunnels.
Main tunnels.
We'll see if we can get down to the next one.
What's that?
I don't know, but those little plastic things were scattered all the way down that corridor.
I don't know what they are.
I thought they'd just been dumped. But
no, but they're not. There's something up there.
It must be like Bakelite or something. Because yeah. They look like plastic, obviously, like back in the 1940s.
Yeah, sure.
This was built in 1940, late 1940.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll place another one, which I think fell into the sea.
Steel girders, that went right along there. Rusting away, yeah.
Shame.
It is a shame. Right, I suppose. We'll get to the next part of the tunnel.
Yeah,
let's get to the next part of the tunnel. Right, we've just come up from that tunnel, so Emma's going to...
We are now back at the North Gun House,
yeah.
And I'm gonna get down this tunnel finally.
I want to go, I just physically can't go.
It's a little bit too small for you.
Yeah.
I'm quite nervous about it, obviously, but I'm excited, because I've seen some pictures of this and I've been wanting to do it for ages. So I'm going to try to squeeze myself down there without getting covered in mud.
Yeah, well, I've got covered in mud getting out, so... But yeah, we'll see.
All right then, well, I'll take you down then.
Right, so see you in a second. Right, yeah. Here we go, and it's going. Just got to go through this.
Somebody's obviously tried to block it up.
They have tried before.
This could have been part of the old searchlights that were here or something, maybe.
Could have been.
But I've never done this before, so I'm quite nervous.
No, this is the first time Emma's going down here.
I've just spotted a bunch of sticky nettles at the entrance, which is brilliant.
Okay. Well, I'm going to throw the camera down to her when she's down.
Yeah, I've got no idea really how I'm going to do this. When I do it.
No, I know.
Jesus.
You alright?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Alright. When she's down there, I'll throw the camera down to her.
Oh, God, there's a drop.
Is there? How deep?
Oh, no, it's alright. Oh.
Alright. Okay.
And
there's the camera. I'm going to put the light on for you.
Alright.
Always on. There you go.
Alright then.
Alright, go for it.
Oh, you could have given me a chance to check for dead bodies before I came
it's
down right. here. Oh,
give me a shout. And
right,
get on back.
Let's get it the right way round. Right then. Well, this is certainly cleaner. Like I said, I've not been done it before, so I don't really know what to expect. Unfortunately, it's not picking up as well as I'd like to hope. But this is pretty much a replica of the other one, minus so much rats, hopefully. Just a few bits and bobs on the floor there. Yeah, this is pretty clean. Just a little room, probably for storage or ammunition, or could have been anything. Ventilation pipe there. Yeah, I imagine that would have gone up to the top. Yeah, not really an awful lot to show you, to be honest with you. But I'll take you down this tunnel, just to the north here. There you go. Hope you can see that well enough. This goes down to a bit of a room. There's a bit of original wood up there. Through to, all right, through to this little room here. Which is almost the same as the first room we took you into. But it's got these things. Looks like possibly they had some sort of storage lockers, or maybe it could have been a table at the end here. Sorry, I'm not very steady because I'm tripping over stuff. Would have been an entrance, no doubt. Let me just see if it just goes up or whether it actually goes down another tunnel. Nah, there's another way in. Look, it's been blocked up, as you can see. So yeah, I love coming down these things. Always fascinates me to think about all the men that would have been down here in these conditions. Can only imagine really what they went through, not knowing if they were going to get invaded or not. Yeah, would have been a little stove, no doubt, down there. But what we've got, just bits of concrete. Oh, this looks like an old gatepost. It's quite interesting. I mean, it could have been from the old Cold War Orlit gate that would have probably been surrounded by it, because it doesn't look like anything we've ever seen from World War II before. Maybe I'm wrong, you can tell me maybe. But that, I believe, I don't know if you can see that. Now let me take my main light off. Looks like it could have been barbed wire or something. Because this whole site would have been surrounded by a barbed wire fence. And as you can see, a lot of the rubbish just got thrown down here. But I think that's all there is to show you, I'm afraid. But it's pretty neat that I finally got down here. Shame that Stu couldn't join me. But I'm sure you'll enjoy seeing the footage. Right, well, I think we're going to get back up.
Right, okay, I know it's a bit windy, but we're travelling over to the Type 22 pillbox. So we're going to be going through that now. I'm going to guide them around because it's a little bit on the old boggy side. But doesn't smell of urine in here.
It smells a bit outside.
Yeah, it does outside. But as you can see, we've got the anti ricochet wall, big old loopholes, which is pretty good to see. Some of them have been bricked up and adapted. Not a very big pillbox, this one.
No, it's not very. 22 is very small.
Yeah.
And this was also surrounded by three Type 27s, I believe.
Yeah.
Further north and south, a bit of a distance away.
Yeah.
We might take some pictures of them if we pass by.
Yeah, we need to get the car out first though.
Yeah, we've got a bit stuck in mud.
Yeah, so we'll...
This isn't the best access road. We recommend if you're going to come and have a look, maybe park in the village and walk.
Yeah, walk up. Yeah, it's not far. So, all right then. So we've had a look around that. We'll do a scan of this. Yeah.
I'm gonna take you over to these spigot mortars that are... Where are they?
Just there.
Over there. Yeah.
Just here.
I'm going to take some pictures of them. Obviously, I'm sure you all know what spigot mortars wear. Guns and stuff on them.
That's it.
There's three of them in all that we found.
Okie dokie.
They've been moved, obviously, from their locations.
Yeah.
And then
we're going to get going.
Goodbye to you.
So, we'll see you in a second. Right, I know it's really, really windy. We're going to say goodbye now, so if you can hear us.
I hope you've enjoyed this and you found it really interesting. It's amazing what you've got on your doorstep. I live just, half an hour down the road from this.
Yeah.
It's absolutely fascinating.
So, as from Exploring with Emma Stu.
Yep, thanks for watching.
Bye.